Quit by John Greenleaf Whittier. When things go wrong, as they sometimes will, when the road you're treading seems all uphill, when the funds are low and the debts are high, and you want to smile but you have to sigh, when care is pressing you down a bit, rest if you must, but don't you quit. Life is strange with its twists and turns, as every one of us sometimes learns. And many a failure comes about when he might have won had he stuck it out. Don't give up though the pace seems slow. You may succeed with another blow. Success is failure turned inside out. The silver tint of clouds of doubt. And you never can tell just how close you are. It may be near when it seems so far. So stick to the fight with your hardest hit. It's when things seem worse that you must not quit.
Don't quit. When things go wrong as they sometimes will, when the road you're charging seems all uphill, when the funds are low, when the debts are high, and you want to smile but you have to sigh, when care is pressing you down a bit, rest if you must, but don't you quit. Life is strange with its twists and turns, as every one of us sometimes learns. And many a failure comes about when he might have won had he stuck it out. Don't give up though, the pace seems slow. You may succeed with another blow. Success is failure turned inside out, the tint of the cloud of doubt. And you never can tell just how close you are. It may be near when it seems so far. So stick to the fight when your heart is hit. It's when things seem worse that you must not quit.
When things go wrong, as it sometimes will, when the road you're trudging seems all uphill, when the funds are low and the debts are high, and you want to smile but you have to sigh, when care is pressing you down a bit, rest if you must, but don't you quit. Life is strange with twists and turns, as every one of us sometimes learns. And many a failure comes about when he might have won had he stuck it out. So don't give up till the pace seems low. You may succeed with another blow. Success is failure turned inside out, the silver tint of the clouds of doubt. And you never can tell how close you are. It may be near when it seems so far. So stick to the fight when your heart is hit. It's when things seem worse that you must not quit.
The Golden Touch. There was once a king named Midas who did a good deed for a satyr and was granted a wish by the god of wine, Dionysus. For his wish, Midas asked that whatever he touched would turn to gold. Although Dionysus tried to dissuade him, Midas insisted that the wish was an excellent one, and it was granted. Exactly, Midas went about touching all sorts of things, turning them into gold. Soon, Midas became hungry. He picked up a piece of food, but he couldn't eat it, for it had turned to gold on his hand. "I'll starve," moaned Midas. Perhaps this was not such a good wish after all. Midas' beloved daughter, seeing his dismay, threw her arms about him to comfort him, and she too turned to gold. "The golden touch is no blessing," cried Midas. He went to the river land wept. The sand of the river turned as yellow as the pool's gold, for it is there. They sing that King Midas washed away the curse of the golden touch with his own tears.
The golden touch. There was once a king named Midas who did a good deed for his sucker and was granted a wish by the god of wine, Dionysus. For his wish, Midas asked that whatever he touched would turn to gold. Although Dionysus tried to dissuade him, Midas insisted that the wish was an excellent one, and it was granted. Excitedly, Midas went about touching all sorts of things, turning them into gold. Soon, Midas became hungry. He picked up a piece of wheat, but he couldn't eat it, but it had turned into gold in his hand. I'll starve, thought Midas. Perhaps this was not such a good wish after all. Midas' beloved daughter, seeing his despair, threw her arms around him to comfort him, and she too turned to gold. The golden touch is no blessing, cried Midas. He went to the river and looked. The sand of that river turned as yellow as fool's gold, for it is there, they say, that Midas washed away the curse of the golden touch with his own tears.
Very well, officer. Take me to your headquarters. Good morning, Captain.
No, Captain. You are mistaken. I was once a good girl, just like the rest of you here, just like any of your daughters. But time was when I was reared in slums. But we live honestly. We live honestly in life. My father, my mother, brother, sister, and I. But then, poverty entered the portal of our home. My father became jobless. My mother got ill. The small savings that my mother had kept for our expenses were spent. All for our daily needs and her needed medicine. One night, my father went out, telling us that he would come back in a few minutes with plenty of food and money. But that was the last time I saw him. He went with another woman. If only I could lay my hand on his neck, I would wring it without pain until he breathed no more. If you're in my place, you'll do it. Won't you, Captain? What? You won't still believe in me? Come, and I'll show you a dilapidated shanty by a railroad. Mother! Mother, I'm home! Mother? Mother! There, Captain! See my dead mother! Captain, there are tears in your eyes. Now, pack this stolen money and return it to the owner. What would this do to my mother now? She's already gone. Do you hear me? She's already gone. Am I to be blamed for the things I have done?
I have enough money now. Yes.
apartment. Father! Father!
Let me go! Let me go! Before you listen to me!
Very well, officer. Take me to your headquarters.
No, they must have captured me. I have enough money now. Yes, enough for my starving mother and brothers. Please, let me go. Let me go home with Princess me.
Very well, sis.
Take me to the quarters. Good morning, Captain. No, Captain, you're mistaken. I was once a good girl just like the rest of here, just like any of the others. That time was when I was reading slums. But we live honestly. We live honestly in life. My father, mother, brother, sister, and I. But then, poverty is the problem. My father became jobless. My mother got ill. The small savings that my mother had kept were spent. All of our daily needs were reignited missing. One night, my father went out telling us that he would come back in a few minutes. With plenty of food and money. But that was the last time he saw. He was another woman. If only I could lay my hands on his neck, I would wring it with a pain from the Christ mother. If you were in a place, you'll do it, won't you, Captain?
What?
You will still believe in me? Come, and I'll show you a dilapidated shanty by our road. Mother? Mother, I'm home. Mother?
see my dead mother. God, and there are tears in your eyes. Your Pakistan and money and return it to the other.
She's already gone.
Do you hear me? She's already gone.
Goodbye for the things you have done.
Don't quit. When things go wrong, as they sometimes will, when the road you're trudging seems all uphill, when the funds are low and the debts are high, and you want to smile but you have to sigh, when care is pressing you down a bit, rest if you must, but don't you quit. Life is strange with its twists and turns, as every one of us sometimes learns, and many a failure comes about when he might have won had he stick it out. Don't give up though pace seems slow. You may succeed with another blow. Success is failure turned inside out. The silver tints of the clouds of doubt. And you can never just tell how close you are. It may be near when it seems so far. So stick to the fight when your heart is hit. It when things seem worse that you must not quit.
The Golden Touch. There was once a king named Midas who did a good deed for a satyr and was granted a wish by the god of wine, Dionysus. For his wish, Midas asked that whatever he touched would turn into gold. Although Dionysus tried to dissuade him, Midas insisted that the wish was an excellent one and it was granted. Excitedly, Midas went about touching all sorts of things, turning them into gold. Soon, Midas became hungry. He picked up a piece of food, but he couldn't eat it, for it had turned into gold into his hand. "I'll starve," moaned Midas. Perhaps this was not such a good wish after all. Midas' daughter, seeing his dismay, threw her arms about him to comfort him. And she too turned into gold. "The golden touch is no blessing," cried Midas. He went to the river and wept. The sand of that river turned as yellow as fool's gold, for it is there. They say Midas washed away the curse of the golden touch with his own tears. The end.
The Golden Touch. There was once a king named Midas who did a good deed for a satyr and was granted a wish by the god of wine, Dionysus. For his wish, Midas asked that whatever he touched would turn to gold. Although Dionysus tried to dissuade him, Midas insisted that the wish was an excellent one and it was granted. Excitedly, Midas went about touching all sorts of things, turning them into gold. Soon, Midas became hungry. He picked up a piece of food, but he couldn't eat it, for it had turned to gold in his hand. "I'll starve." Perhaps this was not such a good wish after all. Midas' beloved daughter, seeing his dismay, threw her arms about to comfort him, and she too turned to gold.
"The golden touch is no blessing," cried Midas.
He went to the river and wept, and the sand of that river turned as yellow as false gold, for it is there. They say that King Midas washed away the curse of the golden touch with his own tears.
Am I to be blamed? They're chasing me! They're chasing me! No, they must not catch me. I have enough money now. Yes, enough for my starving mother and brother. Please let me go. Let me go home before you imprison me. Very well, officers. Take me to your headquarters. Good morning, Captain. No, Captain, you are mistaken. I was once a good girl, just like the rest of you here, just like any other daughter. But time was when I was huge in slums. We live honestly in life. My father, mother, brother, sister, and I. But then, poverty enters a part of our home. My father became jobless. My mother got ill. The small saving that my mother had kept for our expenses were spent, all for our daily needs and her needed medicine. One night, my father telling us that he would be back in a few minutes with plenty of food and money. But that was the last time I saw him. He went to another woman. If only I could lay my hands on his neck, I would drink it without pain until he breathes no more. If you were in my place, will you do it? Won't you, Captain? What? You won't still believe in me? Come and I'll show you a dilapidated shanty by a railroad. Mother, mother, I'm home. Mother, mother. There, Captain, see my dead mother. Captain, there are tears in your eyes. Now pack the stolen money and return it into the owner. What good would this do to my mother now? She's already gone. Do you hear me? She's already gone. Am I to be blamed for the things I have done? Am I to be blamed?
Am I to be blamed? They're chasing me. No, they must not catch me. I have enough money now. Enough for my starving mother and brothers.
Please let me go. Let me go home before you imprison me. Very well, officers. Take with your headquarters.
Good morning, Captain. No, Captain. You are mistaken. I was once a good girl, just like the rest of you here, just like any of your daughters. But time was when I was reared in slums. But we lived honestly in life. My father, mother, brothers, sisters, and I. But then, poverty enters the portal of our home. My father became jobless. My mother got sick. Oh, the small savings that my mother had kept for our expenses were spent. All for our daily needs and we needed medicine. One night, my father went out telling us that he would come back with plenty of food and money. But that was the last time I saw him. He went with another woman. If only I could lay my hands on his neck, I would drink it without pain until he breathes no more. If you were in my place, you'll do it, won't you, Captain? What? You won't still believe in me? Come and I'll show you a dilapidated shanty by the railroad. Mother, mother, I'm home. Mother, mother, there. Captain, see my dead mother? Captain, there are tears in your eyes. Now, pack this stolen money and return it to the owner. What good will this do to my mother now? She's already gone. Do you hear me? She's already gone. Am I to be blamed for the things I have done?
They're chasing me! They're chasing me! No,
they must not catch me. I have enough money now. Yes! Yeah, enough money for my starving mother and brothers.
Please let me go. Let me go home before you imprison me.
Very well, officers. Take me to your headquarters. Good morning, Captain. No, Captain. You are mistaken. I was once a good girl, just like the rest of you here. Just like any of your daughters. But time was when I was reared in slums. But we live honestly in life. My father, mother, brothers, sisters, and I. But then poverty enters the portals of our home. My father became jobless. My mother got ill, and the small savings that my mother had kept was expenses we spent, all for her daily needs and her needed medicine. One night, my father went out, telling us that he would come back in a few minutes with plenty of food and money. But that was the last time I saw him. He went with another woman. If only I could lay my hands on his neck, I would wring it until he breathes with no pain, until he breathes no more. If you were in my place, you'll do it. Won't you, Captain? What? You won't still believe in me? Come, and I'll show you a dilapidated shanty by a railroad. Mother, mother, I'm home. Mother, mother? There, Captain. See my dead mother. Captain, there are tears in your eyes? Now, pack this stolen money and return it to the owner. What good would this do to my mother now? She's already gone. Do you hear me? She's already gone. Am I to be blamed for the things I have done?
Am I to be blamed for the things I have done?
Chasing me, they're chasing me. No, they must not catch me. I have enough money now. Yes, enough for my starving mother and brothers. Please let me go home before you imprison me. Very well. Officers, take me to your headquarters. Good morning, Captain. No, Captain, you're mistaken. I was once a good girl, just like the rest of you here, just like any of your daughters. But time was when I was reared in slums. But to live honestly in life. My father, mother, brothers, sisters, and I. But then, poverty enters the portals of our home. My father became jobless. My mother got ill. The small savings that my mother kept for our expenses were spent, all for our daily needs and her needed medicine. One night, my father went out, telling us that he would come back in a few minutes with plenty of food and money. But that was the last time I saw him. He went with another woman. If only I could lay my hands on his neck, I would wring it without pain until he breathes no more. If you're in my place, you'll do it, won't you, Captain? What? You won't still believe in me? Come, and I'll show you a dilapidated shanty by a railroad. Mother? Mother? I'm home. Mother? Mother? There, Captain, see my dead mother. Captain, there are tears in your eyes. Now pack this stolen money and return it to its owner. What good will it do to my mother now? She's already gone. Do you hear me? She's already gone. Am I to blame for the things I have done?
There's a girl in my mirror. I wonder who she is. Sometimes I think I know her. Sometimes I really wish I did. There's a story in her eyes. Lullabies, everybody. When she's looking right at me, I can tell her heart. I could tell her not to be afraid. wish there was something I could do.
Politely, I guess that I forgot.
mom.